took the hill before the Sandmanch realized what was going on and immediately began pelting the Sandmanch with missiles. In the confusion, Ossus was able to withdraw his army to safety, but Decius was left on the hill, surrounded by an army of angry Sandmanch who had just been denied a piece of victory. Secure on the high ground, the Roman detachment was able to hold out until nightfall, at which point, recognizing the hopeless position, they decided to risk death by sneaking through the Sandmanch army, rather than remaining on the hill and risking the starving to death. They'd gone about halfway through the camp when one of the soldiers dropped a shield on the sleeping Sandmanch. Decius immediately began yelling at his men to attack anything. The Sandmanch, half asleep, panicked by the sudden violent commotion, did not know what or who to attack. Decius and his men made a break through the army, killing everything in their path. When they emerged on the other side, Decius took a head count and realized to his great pleasure that it would come to the men he had led on a sure suicide mission if he had not lost a single man. In the morning, they made their way to the Roman camp and were greeted to thunderous applause. Cossus was about to launch into a speech praising Decius, but the tribune cut him off, saying that the Sandmanch were in complete disarray and the time to finish the job was now. Cossus took the advice and sent his army out. The Romans found the Sandmanch exactly as Decius had described, in confused disarray, attacked them immediately, and won easily. The Romans had now won their first two engagements with the Sandmanch, but the first had been an unexpectedly harsh slog, and the latter would have been a disaster had not been the tactical blunder the Sandmanch had committed by not immediately falling on Cossus' allegiance. The third and final battle of the war was fought at near the border between Campania and Samnium. Envoys from that city came to Marcus Corvus with news that the army he had driven off was regrouping and planning to reinvade. Corvus ordered his army forward all haste, leaving behind all non-essential personnel and gear, marching only with his infantry, cavalry,
after 100 yards, you have reached your destination.
This decision to pack light proved, unexpectedly, to be the decisive factor in the fight.
You have reached your destination.
When Corvus arrived at Sisula, he ordered a camp built. Due to the paucity of men and material, the camp turned out to be physically much smaller than the Sandmanch were used to seeing the Romans build. They assumed this meant that a smaller force was encamped, and all their strategic decisions flowed from this faulty assumption. They decided that the best course would be to starve the small Roman garrison out and began preparing for a siege. The Samnite commanders